क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव, यू कैन सी इट इज सेइंग दैट प्रूव दैट द परपेंडिकुलर एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट टू द टेंजेंट टू अ सर्किल पासिस थ्रू द सेंटर. सी सपोज दिस इज योर परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम सेंटर, दिस इज द सेंटर ओ इन सर्किल एंड परपेंडिकुलर एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट दिस इज टेंजेंट ए बी एंड this where radius and tangent are meeting, this is called the point of contact. So this is the point of contact. So you have to prove that perpendicular OC at a tangent AB passes through center OC. This you have to prove. So for short while, suppose that perpendicular does not pass through center O. Suppose this perpendicular passes through O dash. Fine. So solution I'm doing here, you can see given OC is perpendicular on tangent AB. So here let perpendicular perpendicular does not pass through through O, it passes through, let it passes through passes through O dash. So since perpendicular passes through O dash, we are assuming it. So join it now. Join O dash G. So now students, you can see here, since radius is perpendicular to the tangent, so we can say that angle OCB equal to what? 90 degree. This is equation 1. This is given to you since O is the center. And when O dash is perpendicular on tangent AB, so we can say that angle O dash CB will also be 90 degree. This is equation 2. Now from equation 1 and 2, you can see that both are 90, so these will also be equal. Angle OCB equal to what? Angle O dash CB. Fine. And this is possible, this condition is possible only if O dash C and OC coincide. Fine. So students, we can say that these line, when these both the perpendiculars OC and O dash will coincide, so we can say there will be only O point, that is the center of circle, and this perpendicular OC will pass through center. So we can say that our assumption is wrong. O dash will not exist, and if O dash exists, these line will be coincident. So we can say that OC perpendicular at the point of contact passes through center O. Fine. So students, you write it completely. Perpendicular at the point of contact to the tangent passes through the center O. Fine. Full line you will write yourself. You can see it. Now question number 6 we are going to solve. Question number 6 is saying the length of tangent from a point A at the distance 5 cm from the center of circle is 4 cm. Let this is the point A this is the point A, and length of tangent from a point A at the distance 5 cm from the center of circle is 4 cm. You read only this, length of tangent is 4 cm first. So you will get this is 4 cm. Fine. And length of tangent from a point A at the distance 5 cm from the center of circle. So this will be the 5 cm. Got it? Now you join it with radius. Like this. What do you get here? Here you will see that this angle is 90 because this is the point of contact, of radius and tangent, and this is the 90 degree angle. So in triangle OAB, angle B is 90 degree. Apply Pythagoras theorem, you will get this is the hypotenuse. OA square equal to what? OB square plus this is what? AB square. AB here is 4. 4 square. Fine. OA is what? That is giving you 5 cm. So 5 square minus 4 square equal to OB square. This will be 25 minus 16, 9 equal to OB square. And OB you get what? Under root 9 means 3. 3 cm. This is the answer, means OB radius is 3 cm. R equal to 3 cm. So now we are going to solve question number 6. It is saying that two concentric circles are of radius 5 and 3 cm. Find the length of chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. So means here you can see these are the two concentric circles. Concentric circles are those circles whose center is same. So draw the chord of the larger circle. Let this is the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. Fine. So this is the center of circle O. Join this. This is the radius of bigger circle, that is 5 cm. And join this here also. OB is the radius of smaller circle. So this is also given 3 cm. So students, you can find this AB length. Fine. So in triangle AOB, you can join this also. In triangle AOB, angle B equals to 90 degree. Because we know that tangent perpendicular from center bisect the chord, as well as we know that radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So here we can say radius is perpendicular to the center. That's why we have taken angle B equals to 90 degree. So by Pythagoras theorem, we can say that AO square, this is the hypotenuse, 90 degree is this, so this hypotenuse AO square equal to OB square plus AB square. What is OA? 5 square equal to OB is what? 3 square plus AB is, we have to find AB square. 25 minus 9, what do you get? AB square. This is 16 equal to AB square. What do you get here? AB equal to under root 16 means 4. So AB we have got 4. Since you know that, perpendicular from center bisect the chord. So that's why we can say AB equal to what? BC. And this C point, BC. So we can also say that AC equal to what? AC equal to double of AB. Since these parts are equal, so AC equal to double of AB we can write. And here you know that AB is what? AB is 4. So you get, here you can see 8 cm. and this is the length of chord AC. Now I am solving question number 8. Question number 7. A quadrilateral ABCD is drawn to circumscribe a circle. Prove that AB plus CD equal to AD plus BC. Students, circumscribe means you will draw quadrilateral outside the circle and that will touch the circle also. Fine. So now you can see here, this is the figure, required figure according to question. What is our ABCD? Let this is the center O of circle. Students, you know that suppose this is the circle given to you. If you draw tangent from external point A, these tangent you draw. So these tangent will be equal. Tangent drawn from external points are equal. Fine. You can see here also. Here like this. You are given that this is tangent and this is also tangent. So this is the point A. So these tangent will also be equal. What? Name it. E, F, G, H means AE equal to what? AF. These tangent will also be equal because A is the external point from where we are drawing the tangent on the circle. So you remember the theorem. Tangent drawn from same external point are equal. Fine. So now we can say that we have to prove this. Since so now first of all you see AB is this line segment. First of all, take AB in two parts, means AF you take. AF equal to what? AE we can write through this theorem, equation 1. Now you see second part of AB, FB you take. FB equal to what? This also be external point and tangent are drawn BF and BG. So these will also be equal. Fine. So right here, BF equal to BG. This equation 2 you suppose. Now see here, CD line segment. CD is what? This is CD line segment. Take CD in two parts. First of all, take DH. DH equal to what? DH equal to DE, we can write from the same theorem, D external point and these tangent will be equal. Now you take C external point, then these tangent CH and CG will be equal. Since we are taking DC, so we have taken D and DH here. Now we will take HC. SC equal to what? CG, equation 4. Now add all the equations. Add equation 1. Add equation 1, comma 2, comma 3 and 4. What do you get? AF plus FB plus DH plus HC equal to here AE plus BG plus DE plus CG. Fine. So now what do you get? AF plus FB, AB. DH plus SC, DC, or we can say CD, AE plus BG, AE plus BG. We are not getting AD here. So we have to arrange AE with ED such a way that we will get AD. So AE right here, plus you write DE first with AE, then write BG plus CG. Now you see AV plus CD equal to what we have got AE plus DE, that is AD, and this is BG plus CG, that is BC. So this is the required proof that we have got here. Thank you.